Good morning, students. Today we are going to start a new chapter, chapter 18, pollution of air and water. In this chapter, we will learn about, especially about air and water pollution. We will study in this chapter about the harmful substances which are increasing in our surrounding day by day and how they are affecting our lives. So, I am starting the chapter. First of all, we will discuss the term air. What is air? You all are aware that air is mixture of gases. Air is a mixture of gases. Air is a mixture of gases. And if we talk about the composition of air, you all are aware that in the composition of air, by volume 78% of air consists of nitrogen. In air, nitrogen is 78%, oxygen 21%, and carbon dioxide, it is estimated 0.03%, but it is increasing day by day, and 0.97% other gases like methane, argon, nitrogen oxide, these other gases are also present in the air. Water vapor, ozone, these are also present in air. So, air is a mixture of gases, and when we say that air pollution, it means contamination of air by unwanted substances. So, what is air pollution? How to define air pollution? Pollution means contamination of any natural resource by the unwanted substances. So, when we say about air pollution, then it means contamination of air. Air pollution, how to define air pollution? Contamination of air. By harmful substances, unwanted substances. Harmful, unwanted substances. When harmful, unwanted substances are present in the air, it gets contaminated and we say that it is air pollution. And these harmful substances which contaminate air, they are called air pollutant. So, what do you understand by the term air pollutant? Air pollutant, the harmful substances that contaminate the air. They are called air pollutants. So, what can be air pollutant? It can be smoke. Unburned carbon particles. Harmful exhaust from the vehicles containing harmful gases. Harmful gases like nitrogen oxide, sulfur dioxide. Even carbon dioxide, when present in large amount, then it also acts as a pollutant. So, I hope now it is clear to you what is air pollution. So, when air gets contaminated by unwanted substances and it has harmful effect on the living beings, even on the non-living things also, then we call it air pollution. This air pollution not only affects the living organism, but it will also affect the non-living things. They also corrode the non-living things. And what do you understand by the term air pollutants? The harmful substances that contaminate air, they are called air pollutants. Smoke, unburned carbon particle, harmful gases like nitrogen dioxide, trioxide, sulfur dioxide, these all are air pollutant. Now we will discuss air pollution in detail. First of all, we will talk how does air get polluted. How does air get polluted? Air get polluted. You all are aware that exhaust from the vehicles, from the factories, these all added to the air pollution. So some natural sources are also there for which causes air pollution, like in any volcanic eruption, it is a natural calamity. So when there is volcanic eruption or when there is forest fire, then pollution in the air increases naturally. So human factor causes air pollution, but here when the volcanic eruption is there, when the forest fire is there, then these are the natural calamities. So nature is now responsible for this type of air pollution. During volcanic eruption, harmful gases come out of the volcano. During forest fire also, smoke, unburned carbon particles, they come out. Dust also, these all increases the air pollution. And this is about the nature, how nature cause air pollution. Human activities, undoubtedly human activities are also responsible for increasing air pollution. Like burning of fuel. When we burn fuel, then harmful gases comes out, which causes air pollution, right? And smoke from the factories, power plants, automobile exhaust, right? Smoke from factories, power plants where coal is burned, power plant, vehicle exhaust. Vehicle exhaust, all these increase air pollution, and these all are human activities, right? So by these activities, pollution of the air causes, it increases, and many respiratory problems are caused by air pollution. What are the harmful effects of air pollution? It mainly affects our respiratory system. So many respiratory problems are caused by air pollution. Vehicles, they produce a high level of pollutants like carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, nitrogen oxide and smoke. So when fuel is burned inside the vehicle, harmful gases like carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, oxide of nitrogen and sulfur dioxides, these are released. So gases like carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide is produced in incomplete combustion of the fuel. So carbon monoxide is produced when there is incomplete burning of fuel. Carbon monoxide ऑक्साइड इज अ वेरी हार्मफुल गैस एंड इट इज फॉर्म्ड व्हेन देयर इज इनकम्प्लीट बर्निंग ऑफ फ्यूल. अदरवाइज कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इज प्रोड्यूस. When a fuel is burned completely, then carbon dioxide is gas is produced. But in case the fuel burned incompletely, when there is less oxygen, then there is incomplete burning of fuel. And carbon monoxide gas is produced. It is a poisonous gas. It is a poisonous gas. It is a poisonous gas and it reduces the oxygen carrying capacity of the blood. Inside the blood there is hemoglobin which carry oxygen, but this carbon monoxide prevent hemoglobin to carry oxygen. It attaches, it adheres with hemoglobin and prevents hemoglobin to carry oxygen. So in this way we can say that it reduces oxygen carry capacity of the blood. Because it itself attaches with the hemoglobin. Hemoglobin oxygen carry करता है blood में, लेकिन carbon monoxide hemoglobin के molecule के साथ attach हो जाती है और oxygen carry करने से उसे prevent करती है. So इस case में death भी हो सकती है in deprivation of oxygen. Oxygen की कमी की वजह से जो person इस carbon monoxide के atmosphere में है, उसकी death हो सकती है. It is a poisonous gas. It reduces oxygen carrying capacity of the blood, carrying capacity of the blood. We are talking about the air pollutant. We are discussing air pollutant one by one. First, I have taken carbon monoxide. I have told you that this gas is produced by incomplete burning of fuel. जब fuel को sufficient oxygen नहीं मिलता, तो वो completely burn नहीं होता. और ऐसे में carbon monoxide gas produce होती है, which is a poisonous gas. It reduces oxygen carrying capacity of the blood. It prevents hemoglobin from carrying oxygen. Now the next pollutant of air we will discuss carbon dioxide. What are the harmful effect of carbon dioxide if it is present in excess? Carbon dioxide is a useful gas. How it is useful? Carbon dioxide is taken by plants for preparing food. This gas is used by plant, absorbed by plant for photosynthesis. Plant during photosynthesis take carbon dioxide gas and release oxygen gas. But when carbon dioxide gas is present in excess, then it results in greenhouse effect. So we will talk about greenhouse effect now. Gases like carbon dioxide are called, so it is main greenhouse gas. It is a greenhouse gas. There are some other pollutants which are in greenhouse gas besides carbon dioxide. Other gases like methane, nitrous oxide, and water vapor. Nitrous oxide and water vapor these are also greenhouse gases, but carbon dioxide is the main greenhouse gas present in our atmosphere. So what is greenhouse gas? What is actually greenhouse? Greenhouse is made of glass. सबसे पहले हम समझते हैं greenhouse क्या होता है. ये एक ग्लास का बना हुआ बड़ा सा हाउस होता है वेयर फ्रूट्स एंड वेजिटेबल्स ऑर्नामेंटल प्लांट्स आर ग्रोन. सो ग्रीन हाउस में प्लांट्स ग्रो किए जाते हैं जो कि ग्लास का बना हुआ होता है. ग्लास हैज ए प्रॉपर्टी. ग्लास की क्या प्रॉपर्टी होती है? इट अलाउज द हीट रेडिएशन टू कम इनसाइड, बट इट डज नॉट अलाउ द हीट रेडिएशन टू गो बैक. अंदर तो आने देता है ग्लास हाउस हीट रेडिएशन को, सन की रेडिएशंस को, पर बाहर नहीं जाने देता. एज अ रिजल्ट टेम्परेचर इन द ग्रीन हाउस इज मेंटेन एंड प्लांट्स कैन ग्रो वेल इन विंटर सीजन. इन द विंटर सीजन और यू कैन से इन कोल्ड क्लाइमेट दीज ग्रीन हाउस दीज आर सुटेबल फॉर द ग्रोथ ऑफ प्लांट. एज दीज आर मेड ऑफ ग्लास दे ट्रैप द हीट एंड इन दिस वे सुटेबल टेम्परेचर इज मेंटेन इनसाइड द ग्रीन हाउस एंड प्लांट कैन ग्रो वेल इवन इन कोल्ड क्लाइमेट. सो कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इज ऑल्सो हैविंग द सेम इफेक्ट. सो इट इज कॉल्ड ग्रीन हाउस गैस बिकॉज कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड वेन इट इंक्रीज इन द एयर देन इट हैज ए प्रॉपर्टी दैट इट ट्रैप्स द सन रेडिएशन. कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड भी सन रेडिएशन को ट्रैप कर लेती है. ठीक है. So when sun radiation falls on the earth, some of it is absorbed and most part of it is reflected. The reflected rays are trapped by our atmosphere. Hamara atmosphere un reflected rays ko trap kar leta hai. So if carbon dioxide is more in the air, it will trap more radiation. And as a result, temperature of the earth surface will increase. So if carbon dioxide will increase, then the temperature of the earth will also increase. And this is called greenhouse effect of the carbon dioxide gas. Carbon dioxide gas, it has a property to trap the sun radiation. And thereby it can increase the heat on the earth surface. And this effect is called greenhouse effect. Greenhouse effect means trapping of radiation by the earth atmosphere. Right. So it is called the greenhouse effect. This greenhouse effect results in increasing in the temperature of the earth atmosphere. And finally, it can lead to global warming. Greenhouse effect leads to global warming. Temperature of the earth surface will increase. And as a result, polar ice, glacier, they will melt. As a result, coastal area, they will get submerged in water because the water, the sea level will increase. So, due to greenhouse effect, there will be global warming. Global warming results in melting of the polar ice and glaciers. As a result, the level of sea water will increase. And the coastal areas, they will get submerged in water. And many other natural calamities like flood and drought, that also have to be faced by the human beings and other living organisms. In this way, increase in the carbon dioxide gas will result in harmful impacts on the living organism. So, this was about global warming. So, government of the different country, they are also aware of this fact, and to reduce the emission of greenhouse gases come release ho, iske liye there was a Kyoto Protocol agreement. Kyoto Protocol agreement It is a worldwide agreement between the countries to reduce the greenhouse gases, to reduce the emission of greenhouse gases. Whole world has to face the problems related to global warming. So, global warming has become a major concern for governments worldwide. So student, what I am telling you about Kyoto Protocol agreement, that global warming has become a major concern for governments throughout the world. And many countries have reached an agreement to reduce the emission of greenhouse gases. This agreement is called Kyoto Protocol. It is an example of the agreement which is related to the reduction in the emission of greenhouse gases. Right. So in this way, government they are taking step to reduce the greenhouse gases. Now the next air pollutant we are going to discuss is chlorofluorocarbon. Chlorofluorocarbon has very harmful effect on ozone layer. Chlorofluorocarbon, a protective layer of ozone which is present in stratosphere. Above the troposphere, the next layer of atmosphere is stratosphere. And in stratosphere ozone layer is present. Ozone gas contains 3 atoms of oxygen, O3 molecule. This is the formula of ozone, O3. So ozone layer is present in stratosphere and it protects us from harmful ultraviolet radiation. It protects us from UV rays coming from the sun, from harmful. These ultraviolet rays are very harmful for our skin. They can even cause cancer, disease like cancer. It protects us from harmful ultraviolet rays. But now, due to increase in chlorofluorocarbon in our atmosphere, the ozone layer is depleting day by day. Chlorofluorocarbon, this is used in refrigerator, air conditioner, aerosol sprays. So, this chlorofluorocarbon, this gas is used in refrigerator and AC, air conditioner and refrigerators. This gas is very harmful for ozone layer. Chlorofluorocarbon damages the ozone layer of the atmosphere. And ozone layer protects us from harmful ultraviolet rays. So, if we will not reduce the use of chlorofluorocarbon, then ozone layer will get destroyed. And we will have to face harmful ultraviolet rays. So, nowadays we are trying to reduce the use of chlorofluorocarbon. Now less harmful chemical are used in place of chlorofluorocarbon. Now we are using less harmful chemicals in place of chlorofluorocarbon. Now the next pollutant we are going to talk about is smoke. What is smoke? Smoke is a combination of, it is a mixture of smoke and fog. Smoke plus fog. So, you might have seen a thick fog-like layer in the atmosphere, especially during winter. This is smoke. So, it is made up of smoke and fog. Smoke may contain oxide of nitrogen, which combines with other air pollutants and fog. So smoke, it may contain oxide of nitrogen and other pollutants. It may contain oxide of nitrogen and other pollutant. It combines with fog and form the smoke. Smoke causing breathing problems. It causes breathing problems, asthma. It causes breathing problems. Means it is harmful for our respiratory system. Asthma, अस्थमा, कफ एंड वीजिंग इन चिल्ड्रन. These are the harmful effect of smoke. In this way, smoke is very harmful. It causes many respiratory problems. And some other air pollutants are nitrogen dioxide, nitrogen oxide of nitrogen, and sulfur. On burning fuel, harmful gases, burning fuel like coal. On burning coal, actually in the coal there is an impurity. Sulfur is present in the form of impurity in the coal. Koile ke andar sulfur hota hai as impurity. So when we burn the coal, sulfur dioxide gas is produced. It is produced on burning coal. Maine aapko bataya ki coal ke andar sulfur impurities ke roop mein present hota hai. तो जब आप कोल को बर्न करते हो तो सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड गैस प्रोड्यूस होती है ऑन बर्निंग कोल. एंड दिस गैस इज हार्मफुल इफ इट इज प्रेजेंट इन आवर एटमॉस्फेयर. एंड नाइट्रोजन डाइऑक्साइड इज आल्सो प्रोड्यूस्ड ड्यूरिंग इन पेट्रोलियम रिफाइनरीज. राइट, इन पेट्रोलियम रिफाइनरीज गैसेज लाइक सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड nitrogen dioxide is produced. Now I want to tell you about the harmful effect of these gases, sulfur dioxide and nitrogen dioxide. The oxide of nitrogen and sulfur, they combine with moisture, they combine with the water, and when they fall they form the acid. So gases like sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide, they react with water vapor present in the air. Sulfur dioxide and nitrogen dioxide gas, they combine with water vapor and form the acid. Sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide, they combine with the water vapor and form acid. Sulfurous acid and here also nitric acid they will produce. So sulfur dioxide and nitrogen dioxide gas, they combine with the moisture in the air, or you can say water vapor in the atmosphere, and form sulfuric acid and nitric acid. When this acid comes along with the raindrop, they fall on the earth in the form of acid rain. They comes along with the rain in the form of acid rain. And this acid rain, it can destroy crop, it can damage the skin of human beings, animals, it is dangerous for plants, it can destroy the crops, even the monuments. Acid rain can destroy crop, monuments, in the skin of the animals and human beings. So this was about the air pollutants and their harmful effect. Right, this was all for today. Remaining portion of the chapter we will discuss in next video.